Have you ever gotten in your car and you want to go to the post office on this particular day, but instead you found yourself in your driveway after automatically driving home? That's because your internal GPS, after taking that pathway over and over and over again, automatically takes you back home even though you meant to go to a new destination on this day. Well, porn does the same thing in your brain. Let me tell you how. And in this case, we're talking about real neural pathways. It is called your sex map. And this is shown from new research that the more you traverse the neural pathways back to porn and what you're watching in porn in particular, what I call your arousal template, you might call it a fetish, it is the thing that you've been watching in porn the most, the thing that makes you feel the best, and the thing you find yourself seeking out and having urges toward. That thing has become your sex map. And you may find that you're automatically drawn to go back to that sex map, even though you might not want to. And again, from another new research study, and it's not rocket science, but what it shows is that in the subjective experience, men say that it becomes more of a habit than finding ultimate pleasure there that they think they're going to. So what I mean by that is science shows that men are habitually going back to the genres that have given them the most pleasure and then escalating within those acts or within those genres for more and more pleasure. So here's the idea. That internal GPS that takes you home every day instead of taking you to the post office, it happens because you're traversing the pathway. The pathway from work to home is on autopilot. Your brain has basically told you that at this time of day, leaving from this place, you are going to this place. So you don't even have to think about it. You shut your brain off, and before you know it, you find yourself in your driveway after listening to the radio or whatever it might be. Zoning out, being in your head. And I will bring us back to that in a few minutes. So the idea is when you're on autopilot, you can just be lost in the pathway that you're used to taking. So when it comes to porn, if you've traversed those pathways over and over and over, you will find that that becomes the pull back into porn as you know it. Now it's time for you to be working at your desk and you have an urge or craving for that type of porn. It is because your GPS is set to that type of porn for mood regulation. So just like your car is set to take you home for transportation, porn isn't about sexuality, it is about mood regulation. It's about downshifting stress, offsetting boredom. The number one thing that porn is designed to do is to decrease stress. That's what science shows most men are using porn for. Secondarily, offset boredom. I would contend that boredom is lack of hyperstimulation that people are used to because of porn. And we can cover that at a different time, but the idea is that you're using porn for mood regulation. So in the middle of your work day or before work or before bed, when you feel like you need to watch porn, I want you to ask yourself why. Why do you need it? And the why is for mood regulation, offsetting stress, reducing boredom. So let's go to the idea of these pathways. Now, the pathways that I'm talking about are literal neural pathways in your brain. And what a neural pathway is basically it is neurons that are firing in concert. They're doing it together and it creates an electrical energy pattern in your brain. That pattern can become your operating mode. So what I want for you is that you have an operating mode of calm focus. But when you keep going back to porn, it gives you an operating mode that I call strained brain. Strained brain is a brain that's running too fast, using high beta, very fast, high electrical energy, and running too slow, using a speed called theta, slow speed. It's the speed of feeling groggy. So here's what we have now is we have a brain that's strained in gassing very fast speed and braking simultaneously. Braking and gassing, a wired and tired brain. Now, guess what a wired and tired brain needs? It needs something external to shift it into artificial neutral for a time. The way that porn does that is it is a supernormal stimulus. It is known to produce very high levels of dopamine within your brain. So what happens is it becomes an internalized drug addiction, and the drug is a neurotransmitter, one that's supposed to be linked to your life so that you pursue the things that bring you pleasure, like work and relationships and hobbies, purpose. That in essence is the evolutionary role of dopamine in human development. It's supposed to keep us going in terms of being able to hunt down food and be able to keep our tribe safe and be able to move towards sexual expression and connection with another human being for procreation. That, in essence, is why dopamine exists at healthy levels. But when it becomes distorted and linked to the screen, which is relatively new in terms of evolution, you will find very high levels of dopamine there, a super normal stimulus. So we know that on first and second exposure of porn, your brain changed those pathways. The pathways towards porn for a high level of dopamine became the pathways that your brain wants to take for mood regulation. Hopefully you're following me here. So just like that car is designed for transportation, porn is designed for mood regulation in an unhealthy way. So stay with me because I'm going to give you your brain hack strategy in just a minute. If porn is giving you mood regulation in a healthy way, what else can you do? We'll talk about that in just a minute. But for now, what I want you to know, if you find yourself habitually going back to a specific act or genre, and especially one that doesn't compute in your life, one with very high level intensity, you may have distorted your sex map, which means you have set your GPS back to that, and that doesn't exist in your real life, so it will create problems for you. Again, from another study, we have a quote from one of the subjects that says that the more he watches porn, the less he wants to be with his partner. And the less he watches porn, the more he wanted to be with his partner. And this is a very shared experience from the thousands of clients that I have worked with. Porn is taking you back into the screen and taking you away from the dopamine in your life, especially a healthy sex life with your partner. Okay, so let's double back to this being in your head concept. So if you're in your head, you are using high beta. Being in your head, rumination, having urges and cravings, thoughts that are wired up in your brain, that is the essence of high beta. It is that very fast energy that's screaming at you to decrease it so you can feel better and get back to work, or decrease it so you can feel better and go to sleep. So high beta is the essence of being in your head. And to go to your brain hack strategy for the day is, if the problem is going to porn for unhealthy mood regulation, the solution is staying away from porn and going into your life for healthy mood regulation, doing your favorite things. So doing your favorite things that produce dopamine, serotonin, and oxytocin, what is called the happiness trifecta. So right now, for your brain hack strategy, get out your journal, get out your pen, and write down all the things that you used to love to do. Write down all the things that you love to do and you don't make enough time for them, and all the things you've ever wanted to do. This way, when you want or feel the need to regulate your mood, you know exactly what you're going to do. you're going to go into your life and regulate it in a healthy way. Now, let's call out the elephant in the room, which is it's difficult to break the loop back to porn because it's a super normal stimulus, very high levels of dopamine. So when you start doing your favorite things in your life, they can't compare. Let's call porn a level 15 stimulus. Let's call everything in your life a level 9, right? It's on a 10-point scale. So it could only be a 9 if it was really exciting and very purposeful and felt great to you. Those are healthy levels of dopamine. We want to acclimate your brain back towards those levels, but right now your brain is used to level 15. So you might need help in breaking this negative feedback loop into porn. If you do, please go over to my website. I offer a program called Porn Free Brain Forever. There have been thousands of people who have moved through that program, successfully overcoming the pullback into porn and successfully getting on purpose in their life. And I would love to help you there if it feels right. So hopefully I'll see you over there. If you're not ready for a big comprehensive program that gives you all the tools that you need to unwire, rewire, and hardwire your brain, I've started a new program, a community, and it's only $29 a month. It's so affordable, accessible, and anonymous, just like porn. It's designed to help you use the brain training headband and to help you use your mind and your body to be able to regulate yourself so you don't need porn anymore. So if you're ready to get started in a smaller way, please go over to drtrishleigh.com and join me there. All right. Until next time, control your brain or it'll control you. I'll see you soon.